Hi there. Today, we'll explain the next 13 essential IT terms from the chapter 3.2, Tools and Techniques in Web Design, in our book. You can find the book linked in the description below. Let's dive in. Iteration, the process of refining a design through repeated testing and improvement. We'll go through multiple iterations to ensure the app's design is optimized for usability. Interactivity. Features like clickable buttons, animations, and dynamic forms that allow users to engage with the website. Adding interactivity, like hover effects and animations, makes the website feel more engaging. Breakpoints. Specific screen widths at which the layout changes in responsive design to accommodate different devices. We need to set breakpoints for mobile, tablet, and desktop views to ensure a responsive design. Contrast ratio, the difference in luminance between text and background, crucial for readability and accessibility. Improving the contrast ratio will make the text easier to read for users with visual impairments. SEO optimization. Designing a site to rank higher on search engines by improving its structure, performance, and usability. Our SEO optimization strategy includes fast loading speeds and keyword-rich content. Modularity, the design principle of creating reusable components for consistency and efficiency across a website. Using a modular design approach helps developers maintain and update the website more easily. Micro-interactions, small, interactive design elements like hover effects, loading animations, or button feedback that enhance user experience. A simple micro-interaction, like a button changing color when clicked, makes the interface feel more responsive. Prototype, an interactive model of a website used for testing and demonstrating functionality. Before full development, we'll build a prototype to test usability with real users. Grid system. A structural framework that divides a page into columns and rows for balanced and organized layouts. Using a grid system helps keep the page layout clean and aligned. Typography, hierarchy, the arrangement of fonts and sizes to guide users through content in order of importance. By applying typography hierarchy, we make sure the headlines stand out, while body text remains readable. Color palette, a curated set of colors used to define the visual identity and mood of a website. A consistent color palette strengthens brand identity and improves visual appeal. Responsive images. Techniques that ensure images scale properly across different devices and resolutions to maintain quality. We'll use responsive images so that high-resolution photos load correctly on all screens. User persona. Fictional representations of a website's target audience used to guide design decisions. Creating user personas helps us design features that meet the needs of our audience. Hey, I noticed our website's contrast ratio is too low. The text is hard to read.
Good catch. We should also check our typography hierarchy to make headings stand out more.
Agreed. Also, let's add some micro interactions, maybe hover effects for buttons.
Great idea, and we should improve SEO optimization so our site ranks higher on Google.
Absolutely. I'll work on a prototype, and we can test it before finalizing the design.
Perfect. Let's also use a grid system for better layout structure. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.